Welcome to lecture 33. In this lecture, we will see the phasor diagram of synchronous machine that we have already drawn in the last class. In our last class, we said that in a salient pole synchronous machine, what we do, we take E along x-axis, then it's a generator, so we have drawn V in this direction. Had it been a motor, we will draw it in this direction. That is, in case of a motor, V will lead E. In case of a generator, E will lead V. That's why V is here. We have assumed it to be a lagging load. That's why I is lagging V by some angle. Let's call it as phi. And let's say that the angle between V and E is delta. And we define this angle, that is angle between I and E, as psi. Now, what we will do, we will extend this I and from this I, extension of this IA, we will draw a line perpendicular to this V, perpendicular to IA and passing through the tip of V. So what we have done, we have drawn a line which is perpendicular to IA and it is passing through tip of V. Let's say that this, let's name this point to be O, this point to be A, this point to be B. Now let's say that this point is C. We draw a perpendicular here. Let's call this as D, let this be E, and let this point be F. Okay. Now, we will do some geometry of class 9, but it is important for this, so we will do this geometry. This is a right angle triangle. This angle is psi, so this angle will be 90 degree minus psi. Angle OCB. Angle OCB is equal to 90 degree minus psi. Now, since CD is a perpendicular to OE, therefore, angle BCD is equal to psi. This total is 90 degree, this is 90 degree minus psi. So, this angle is psi. Now, we will write something more that we have done in last class. In last class, we say that this is my IA. We have splitted IA along two components. One is IQ, another is ID. So, let's write again what is ID. ID is equal to IA sine psi. So, this is ID. This angle is psi, so IT is equal to IA sin psi. Or we can write IA is equal to ID by sin psi. So this is one relation that we may need. Again, we can write IQ is equal to IA cos psi. From there we can write IA is equal to IQ by cos psi. We will need this result also somewhere down the line. Now let's look at the triangle. Let's look into the triangle BCD, this triangle. In this triangle, this is my angle psi. This is a right angle triangle. This is my angle psi. So this is my base. This is my perpendicular. This is my hypotenuse. So in this triangle, we can write DC by BC is equal to cosine. Base by hypotenuse equal to cosine. Now, what is DC? DC is equal to EF. What is EF? IQ XQ. So we can write IQ XQ IQ XQ that is DC by BC is equal to cosine. From this we can write BC is equal to IQ XQ by cosine. So from this equation what we can write? We can write this IQ by cosine, this parameter as IA. So we can write BC is equal to IA into XQ. What is BC? BC is this length. This length is IA into XQ. From here to here it is IA into XQ. Now let's continue the derivation. Let's say that this we have found out to be IAXQ. We know that this length is IQXQ. So what will be BD? We can write BD is equal to BD is equal to BD is this length. BD is equal to BF minus DF. Our objective is finally to find DF. So what is, if we can find BD, then we can find DF. Now this BD is nothing but BC sin psi. This is perpendicular, this is hypotenuse. So BD by BC is my sine of psi. So we can write BD equal to BC. What is BC? BC is IAXQ into sine psi. So what is IA sine psi? IA sine psi is my ID. So we can write it here ID into XQ. So BD is equal to ID into XQ. Please understand that this is not ID XD, this is ID into XQ. So this length BD is ID into XQ. I'm not writing it here because it will make it more cumbersome. Okay, let me try to write. This is ID into XQ. Okay, so what will be my DF? DF will be equal to BF minus BF minus BD. So that will be equal to BD, this is equal to IDXD minus BD will be equal to IDXQ. So we have DF is equal to ID into XD minus XQ. So this length from here to here, this length is ID into XD minus XQ. Okay. So why we did this derivation? We did this derivation because we would like to, given a voltage and a current, we have to find E. In non-salient pole machine, how we have done this? In non-salient pole machine, we have written a relation like E of F, we am talking about generator. I am talking about non-salient pole synchronous generator. For this type of machine, what we have written? We have written E of F as a vector is equal to V of T plus IA axis. Here we cannot write like this. Here what we have to write? Here we have to write E of F, that is this one, is equal to V of T, that is this one, plus, okay, let's not write it as E of F. This is for non-salient pole machine. Now, for salient pole machine, what we will do? For salient pole machine, the problem is that we don't know this psi. Why we don't know this psi? The reason is that unless you know E, you don't know the angle between V and E. So this delta is not known. Since this delta is not known, we cannot compute this. So if you look at this phasor diagram, for salient pole machine, what is EF? E of F is equal to V of T, that is this one, plus IDXT, that is this one, plus IQXQ. This is absolutely correct. But to calculate ID, what you need? To calculate ID from IA, you require psi. Now, psi you cannot calculate unless you know this delta. And to calculate delta, you need to know the angle between V and E, which you don't know. So we cannot, in a salient pole machine, we cannot directly evaluate this. The reason is that